Good morning to all. So last class we discussed about Phong elimination model. The Phong elimination model is a summation of ambient light, diffuse and specular, where here we are going to draw element and we are going to apply the Phong elimination model properties, and as well as we are going to enable the lighting properties also. So this is your lab program 6, where we are going to draw a simple shaded scene consisting of a teapot on a table. So we are going to draw suitable the position and properties of the light along with the properties of the surfaces of the solid object which we are going to use in this program, right? So first we are going to see here we are going to draw a wall, table, and upon the table we are going to place a teapot. First, to draw a wall, where the surface you have to draw. So the surface we are going to draw here as xz plane. Whatever transformation you are going to do here, you have to write between GL push matrix and pop matrix, where in graphics whatever polygon you are going to write, which you write start with GL begin and end, like that here whatever transformations you are going to write, you have to start with GL push matrix and end with GL pop matrix. What this push matrix and pop matrix will do? Here, this push matrix will do copies the top matrix in the stack and store copy in second stack position, right? And pop matrix, which will erase the top matrix and moves the second matrix to the top of the stack. And first, to draw a teapot, you have to draw the surface first, the base surface, the ground base surface. So here I'm writing the transformation based on xz plane corner at your origin point, where you can try yz as well as xy plane. Here the transformation I'm starting with GL push matrix. I'm writing the translator matrix value x, y, z, and I'm writing the scale matrix also x, y, z, and which element I'm taking to draw the surface. Here I'm taking a solid cube. This solid cube, I'm applying the transformations to make my ground surface. So I'm drawing a solid cube and I'm transforming to the ground surface. So this is your initial solid cube. After you apply your transformations, this is going to be your output. So once you complete the transformations, you write pop matrix, and which will erase the top matrix in the stack and move the second matrix onto the top of the stack. Okay. Next, I'm going to draw a table. As I said, the first we have drawn the surface. This is the surface, right? So surface we have drawn based on xz plane. So this is the surface. Next, for teapot, you have to draw a leg. Upon the teapot, you have to place the top, right? So to draw a teapot, you have to draw a table leg, where here table leg properties we are defining with thickness and length. So similarly here, you have to draw between your GL push matrix and pop matrix, where you are going to apply the transformation. So translator matrix, where x value is 0, z value is 0, y value is length divided by 2 on your screen, and similarly scaling the thickness and length and thickness, x and z value specify thickness and y value specify the length. What is the transformation object you are using for this leg? Again, I'm using solid cube. So I'm taking a solid cube, I'm transforming to table legs, applying these transformations, right? So here one table leg we have drawn. Similarly, we have to draw four table legs, right? So same you have to apply. Next, after drawn the table legs, upon that you have to draw a table top, right? So here I'm going to draw a table and table legs as well as table top. So applying the transformation between push matrix and pop matrix, first specifying your translated tabletop values, where you are going to draw x value 0, y value leg length and z value 0, and scaling you are going to specify with thick as well as width, where we have written the function with respect to table width as well as table thick and as well as leg length. Same here, I'm using solid cube object. I'm doing the transformation this solid cube object to a tabletop as well as leg. So here I'm using the value distance, where specifying the value 0.95 in multiply with top width divided by 2.0. Why this top width divided by 2.0? Means your screen space will be full. Okay, so divided by 2 of your screen space as well as leg thick, and you are writing the push matrix and you are applying the transformation, where you have to draw four legs. So first leg, the translated value, which will have x value, y value, z value equal to minus 2 into the distance, the which value we defined here. And similarly for the second leg and third leg and fourth leg. So 1, 2, 3, 4, four legs. Upon that you are defining the table top. All table legs as well as table top, you are drawing basically a solid cube object, and you are applying the transformations to draw your leg as well as table top. Okay, and similarly with respect to your table, all four legs specifying leg thickness as well as leg length, where you are drawing between GL push matrix, you are applying the transformation between GL push matrix and pop matrix. Next, you have to display the particular solid cube whatever you have drawn. Okay, so to do the display, as we discussed, any object between the light source and the viewer which hits on the surface, viewer will see the particular reflections or whatever changes happen over there. Okay, so here you have to set the properties of surface material. So here for surface, we already discussed about ambient, diffuse, specular and shininess. And here ambient, you have to write the values or G, B, A. So how we are going to specify each and every light source property, specifying GL float, mat underscore ambient or G, B, alpha value. so which will show the gray value. And for similarly diffuse or G, B and alpha value. Similarly for specular or G, B and alpha value, specifying your shininess 50.0. Here you can write mat underscore ambient, which will apply the properties of ambient, or you can write no mat, so which will be nullified. Okay, so here material properties, how you can write GL material FB, open the bracket, you can specify the position of that light source property. Here we are used GL underscore front. Either you can use GL underscore back or GL underscore front or GL underscore front underscore and underscore back. So all three you can use: GL front, GL back, GL front and back. And specifying your light source property parameter name GL underscore ambient, then specifying the parameter mat underscore ambient. If you write no underscore mat, means no lighting properties will apply here. Okay, you can write, suppose you don't want ambient, you want to be applied only diffuse and specular. In that case, you can write no underscore mat. So that material property will be zero. Or you want only the ambient, you don't want diffuse as well as specular. In that case, you can write no underscore mat, no underscore mat. So here only ambient light will be applied, and the material property of ambient will be applied, and the diffuse and specular will be zero. As well as here also shininess, you can write no mat, only ambient will be, right? So like that, how you can write the material property GL material FB, open the bracket, GL position of that particular material, either you can specify front or back or front and back, GL underscore front for front, GL underscore back for back, GL underscore front underscore and underscore back for front and back, and specify the parameter name, either you are going to use ambient, diffuse, specular or shininess, or you are going to apply the parameter, you can write mat underscore ambient. If you don't want to apply, you can write no underscore mat. Same applicable for diffuse, specular and shininess, right? And set the light source properties. Setting the light source properties, we have discussed now the material properties. Next, about the light source property, how intense the particular light touches the surface, which position of the surface the light source hit, that you are going to specify. Okay, and R G B A alpha value, where you are going to write the intensity of the light and position the light colors, and you are going to specify the light function. Okay, GL underscore light zero, where you can specify the light value between 0 to 1. 0 is the lowest and 1 is the max. You can specify GL underscore light 1 also. You can specify GL underscore light 0. And parameter name, where you are going to use the position and parameter. You are going to use the light underscore position. No light, you can specify no underscore light also. Okay. And for GL underscore light 0 and parameter name, GL underscore diffuse and light intensity, you can specify. Similarly, you can write for specular. And this all about set your light source properties which hits on the surface materials. Next, you are going to viewer point, you are going to view the effects, either it is going to reflect or refract or diffuse. So GL matrix mode, specifying your projection view, load identity, which will replace the current matrix. And here the view, you are going to specify window height equal to 1.0, which means of height of window, the material what you are going to draw, which has to display on your window screen. Suppose you have specified 640 into 480 the window screen, it should take half height of the window and displays. And here we are writing GL ortho function specifying where left, right, bottom, top, near, and for the values. Okay, so specifying your window coordinate value, left, right, bottom, top, near, and for values, and using GL matrix mode, GL underscore model view, and which will replace the current matrix using the load identity function. And similarly, we are using the lookup function. So lookup function, what it will say, I value of the camera I, camera is the I, right? So I value of X, I value of Y, I value of Z, then the reference value, reference point of X, reference point of Y, reference point of Z, and the up vector value X, up vector value Y, up vector value Z, right? And you are going to start draw the surface wall as well as teapot, right? So you are using GL clear for clear buffer width, and for depth if you are going to use double buffer window, right? So initially specifying position of the teapot on table, where you are going to write between push matrix and pop matrix, the transformation you are going to write between push matrix and pop matrix. So translated value, rotated value, and scaled value. Initial position of the teapot. Then you are going to write the teapot rotated value. Okay, what is the rotated value? And similarly, this is for teapot. Similarly, you have to write for table and the surface. Okay, first for the teapot, one thing you can do, this initial position you can completely comment and execute. If any changes happens, you can do. Okay, otherwise you can change in the matrix values. So applying the transformation for solid teapot, what you are going to draw the teapot, and here I have commented solid sphere, so you can enable and you can view the solid sphere as well as teapot. The execution part we will see, and writing a push matrix and applying the transformation for the table, and writing the push matrix, applying for wall 1, wall 2, and wall 3. One is surface, another two walls on X as well as left as well as right. Okay. And going to apply the transformations, and transformations for what? The teapot as well as the table as well as the wall. Okay. And the main, where you are going to specify the window size and double buffered window display mode, and where you are going to specify the position, window name, and calling the display solid, and enable GL lighting. So it will apply the lighting properties. If you can give the enable lighting source minimum value with 0, maximum values with 1, and where we are applying the shade model, where shade model, we have two different shade models. One is GL underscore flat, another one is GL underscore smooth, where you can comment and you can check it. We are enabling the depth test and whatever calculation we are doing, and we have to do with a normalized vector where light hits on the surface and the position with respect to the normal vector value. For that, we are writing the function gl underscore normalize and clear the color and viewport specifying x value, y value, as well as width, as well as height, which the display you are going to view on your window screen. Now we'll see the output. As I said, initial you are going to draw the surface with respect to x, z plane. Okay, this surface you can check x, y plane or y, z plane, you can change. Okay, and based on that, so totally how many walls? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. One wall we made as a surface. This is second and third. Okay. And four table legs and table top. As I said, the transformation here, the initial position of the teapot, and you are going to check with the teapot the transformation, as well as wall 1, 2, and 3 and table, right? And so surface wall, second wall, third wall, okay, and this is also the table, okay, where all wall 1, 2, 3 and this table top we draw from the solid cube. We use to the object a solid cube and we apply the transformations, right? And similarly for this table legs also, this is your output, where upon the table you have specifies the teapot, right? So, and as I said, you can just remove the comment for the solid cube and you can view this also. And this is if I enable, as I said, light source lighting 0 as well as 1. If light maximum value I apply, the visibility will be like this. Okay, we'll see the execution part now. So this is your output when you are going to apply all the transformation from the solid cube. If you are drawing the wall as well as table leg, as well as table top and teapot, as I said, few changes will do and we can check. Okay, and you can see this transformation and all, you try by yourself. Only the lighting source I will just to tell you now. If I apply the light source property 1, okay, so minimum value 0, maximum value 1. So you can see the changes, right? Similarly, you can, and if half of the height, as I said, in the display, your window, suppose if I am specifying 2.0 on your window, half of the height, so it will be viewed like this. Or if I specify 4.0 on the display, this is a viewport, okay, viewport display, so it will be displayed like this. Then I specify the output and you can view like this. And similarly, you can change the values RGBA with respect to diffuse, specular, and as I said, suppose if you are going to change, applying the transformation with respect to wall, suppose if I'm specifying the values, you can see the base surface wall 1 and wall 2. Okay, similarly you can change the value here. You can see this is wall 2 and the surface, for example, here also we'll change the value. Okay, so surface wall, this is wall 1, wall 2, wall 3. You can see the changes. Similarly, for table also, you can apply. Okay, where you can change the values with respect to table. And one more thing, as we mentioned here initially, the wall top XZ plane, the viewing, how we are going to view. See, this viewing is XZ plane. Suppose the viewing I want to change to XY plane, you can see the changes. Suppose here I'm going to change based on XY plane, right? Then what will be the viewing? So this is the XY plane value. You are just changing the transformations, right? And similarly, this is the transformations, right? And suppose if I am writing the solid cube value, if all we are drawing through a solid cube, right? So this will be, the transformations will take place like this. Okay, the transformation will take place and you can do all the changes. And suppose if I'm specifying the solid cube value and applying the transformation with a given value, it'll be like this. Okay, so you can see the changes over here, right? And similarly, distance, okay, the distance top width, as well as you can check the table top, and suppose instead of width I'm specifying the thickness, suppose top thick. See, this is a case sensitive. Whatever you are specifying, top thick as well as width, the thick, you can, the value you have to specify capital T, similarly for W. Okay, and you can see the transformations. Okay, and here actually it was XZ and now it is YZ. So why is that? The output is viewed like that. Okay, so you can change. Right? And suppose if I'm specifying the distance, I'm specifying the distance, you can see from this tabletop surface to this legs. Suppose I'm changing the thickness, leg thickness. You can view the difference, right? So before legs, and the translated the value also. Suppose, for example, your distance value with respect to x, z. Here I'm going to change it to y, z. You can see, okay, the difference. So right, and similarly you can change all the transformations with respect